Look, black is beautiful, shawty, that you should know. Don't let American standards damage your African soul. Natural hair over the weave under. I buy you Givenchy rags and wrap it neat for you. I wrap a feature and buy you pieces from people that you love. Celine Dion pay for that Celine that you got on.
Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited. Oh my god, thank you guys so much for 100,000 subscribers. Okay, I don't want to deviate from this video. I'm actually going to make like a whole separate video for that. But anyway, so today's video is gonna be a tutorial on how I achieved this very easy, nice, cute, fluffy afro kind of hairstyle. As you guys saw, I already went ahead to put lots of water on my hair because my hair was like so strong. Literally. And for this hairstyle, I'm going to make it very easy. So if you cannot braid at all, then this is going to be so perfect for you. So like you guys already saw, I already went ahead to part my hair into two for the front and for the back. And then I took the back, I just started parting my hair roughly into small sections. And then I just started twisting that. I just twisted it all the way to the end. We're just twisting my natural hair. So this is very perfect. Like I said, if you don't know how to braid, you can just go ahead and twist this. Or like, yeah, if you feel like you can braid, you can also go ahead to braid this. So after twisting the back of my natural hair, I went ahead with this weaving net that I've used in two of my videos right now. So this is the third time I'm using this. I'm just going to go ahead to put this on my hair. After putting this weaving net on my head, it actually stays on. But if you feel like you're a little insecure with the net actually staying while you crochet it, you could just go ahead to use a bobby pin and just hold it down on both ends, which I eventually end up taking away this bobby pin, and then normally go ahead to cut out the excess weaving net at the back, and then from there, that's basically the entire base. And then for the crochet hair, I'm using the fluffy wand curl from Freetress. So I went ahead to grab each strand of the crochet hair and then I divide it into three, so just to give it that fluffy look and to make it to look more full. And you guys, guess what, I used only 1.5 pack of hair for this entire head. So that's a good trick. So if you feel like you don't have enough hair, make sure to just separate the hair more. Like, it's going to be enough. If you have only one pack, you'll be fine. Literally, that's one of the reasons I actually love this hair. It's very economical, it's just perfect. You don't need so much hair at all. So I'm just gonna go ahead to keep crocheting this to my natural hair, including the net. And when you're actually crocheting this, you want to make sure that you're passing your crochet hook along with the crochet hair through your natural hair as well as through the net. In that way, it actually helps to keep the net secure, it doesn't move. So you guys will see what I mean. So I go ahead to make sure that I'm passing it through, so through both your natural hair and through the weaving nets, so everything just stays perfectly in place. So you guys asked me what is the point of having this weaving net. Okay, well, there are a lot of reasons. Number one, the first reason is, so if your hair is way longer than mine and even fuller, you can just go ahead to hold your hair and put it into one bun. So in that way, you just go ahead to crochet around the one natural hair bun that you're going to make, just like you see me doing the front. However, if your hair is like really short like mine, it's very hard to put this in one single natural hair bun without using a gel. And I don't really want to use any gel because I want the hairstyle to last me a bit longer, at least 1 week. And then the second reason is, if your hair is very scanty, this actually helps to give you a lot more base for you to actually go ahead to crochet your hair. And then the other thing we could be thinking is, oh, okay, why can't we just do like the single braids or single twist without having to use the net? You could do that, but the problem is, if you do the single braids without having to do the net method, like if your hair is short, you won't be able to cover up for like the scantiness of your hair, number one. And then secondly, if you also just do the braids like that without having to cover it with a net, it's going to poke through your crochet hairstyle depending on the crochet hair you're using. And you don't want to be seeing your braids mixed up with your crochet hairstyle. And when you're taking it down as well, if you don't actually use a net and your hair is just poking around, it gets confusing when I just want to easily cut away the extension that I use. It makes it hard for you to loosen because you have to be very precise so you don't accidentally cut your hair or something. So that's the three or four major reasons I would say that I love using this net method for my hair. So I hope that actually makes sense. I'm sorry, I actually talked a lot. But as you guys saw, I already went ahead to take away the bobby pins that I used for the back to secure the net. And then I went ahead to put the rest of the front of my natural hair in a bun. I used some Eco Styler gel. I tried not to use a lot of gel. I just wanted enough gel that would just hold my front hair in place. Because as you can tell, like the front hair that's left for us to put in a bun is pretty like small. So it's quite easier to put in a bun than putting the entire back in a bun. You know what I mean? So I just went ahead to put that in a bun, and then I went ahead to crochet around this bun to give you like a little high puff kind of illusion. So just make sure you're crocheting around this entire bun in a circular motion. So now that I'm done putting my hair and crocheting everything onto my natural hair, I'm just going to go ahead to grab the front, and then I'll go ahead to use this elastic band, or you can use any hair packer or any thing to just hold it together. So just to cover like the little bun that we have, our natural hair bun that we have, and then I'll just go ahead to fluff this around my hair, just take a little shape, trim it with some scissors, and just kind of, you know, fluff it kind of like a fringe puff. And then I went ahead to add a little bit more gel to sleek my front hair and everything. That's basically the end of this hairstyle. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. I love you guys so much. Have a wonderful, wonderful week. Bye. Mwah. Kill him with the groove, kill his gata. Kill him with the groove, kill his gata. Kill him with the groove, kill his gata. Kill him with the groove, eleganza. Kill him with the groove, kill his gata. Kill him with the groove, kill his gata. Kill him with the groove, kill his gata. Kill him with the groove, eleganza. Baby, let the rhythm control ya. Pull up that thing for me.